All right, guys, for this one, you're going to need 5 different things.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Push-ups, a burpee variation, a squat, tuck jump, and then tricep dips. So, push-up. We all know what a push-up is. You can do them on your knees. You can do them off your knees. But, again, make sure your wrist, your elbow, your shoulders, they're all in line. You can go out wide if you want to. If you are having problems with your wrist that are bent like that, get something to hold them. They make the push-up handles and step off the ground so that your wrists are not bent, they're straight. Or a dumbbell works the same if you can wrap your hand around it and hold it like that. So, push-up. Knees. Again, the closer your knees are to your hands, the easier the push-up is, the farther away. And of course, don't sag like that. Don't push your butt up like this. All right, so this burpee variation, there's no jump and there's no push-up. So basically, your feet are together, you come down, get into plank, and you're just gonna slide. It's gonna be easier if you keep your feet apart and back there a little bit for balance. So side raise, stand up. Down, back, side raise, in, and up. Again, you can take out the jumps, go down, step back into it, and get onto your knees. Step back in, stand up. So squats, we've gone over squats before. What you want to do, keep your knees back, chest is up, shoulders kind of take your shoulders and do this, stick your chest out. Kind of make it round, drop it down into your back. So that's going to keep your chest up. And it's going to push your butt down, and then back in. Down, and then back up. Keep your knees. If you put your hand down like that and it's coming past your toes, you're too far back. You can't go down the whole way without doing that. Don't go down the whole way. This is what you want to work to. But if this is all you can get, and remember, this is not a squat. It doesn't matter how much your head moves. This is not, it doesn't count, all right? It matters how much. This is the biggest movement right here at your knees. Your hips are going to bend as you go down, but not your knees. Alright. Tuck jumps. Now these are tricky without a jump, but I'll show you. So basically your feet are just shoulder width apart, a little bit wider than your hips, shoulder width apart. And you're just going to jump. Touch your knees. Have it. You don't need to do them fast. You can do them fast. You can just or you just do them one at a time. Regroup. 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 If you want to take out the jump, just do one, two. One, this is gonna be two knees are gonna count as one rep. So one, two, that's one, two, that's two. And the last one, tricep dips. You've done it. Done these before, hands at the very edge of your seat or your chair or your whatever, or on the ground. Feet just come a little bit past your hands. You go down by pushing your shoulders, I'm sorry, your elbow back, not wide like a chicken wing, but straight back. Squeeze your back together. The easiest way to do it is keep your butt on the ground. You're going to have to keep your hands back as far as you can go. Your fingertips point towards your toes. So just like that. Down. And make sure you're leaning on your arms. Alright. Make it a little bit more difficult. Pick your butt up off the ground. You don't have as much range of motion as you do on it because it's lifted, but it's still effective. Now, something I see all the time, don't do it. So I see people keep their arms straight like this, and their hips are going down and up, down and up. You are not working your triceps. You're almost working nothing here. You're cheating. You can't go down very deep. Don't go down very deep. Just go down, you know, an inch. Come back up. You gotta squeeze at the top. Release that at the bottom. Squeeze. Alright? Those are your whatever, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, whatever they were.